Today we have an API partner at DrChrono. We met at Y Combinator. That's one of our investors in our company. And essentially when we met, they were in the same healthcare vertical, working in the pharmaceutical side with clinical trials. This is Brian. He's the CEO of the company. And the clinical trial world, there's a lot of friction with getting a clinical trial. Generally, a patient goes into their doctor. They're extremely frantic, ill. The doctor is trying to prescribe the right drugs for, say, a cancer patient. And some of the time, the patients are in extreme duress. The family's under extreme duress. With that stress, they're not thinking about clinical trials and future drugs that may come out on the market that actually might affect them in a positive way. The way that the industry works today is a lot of these hospitals and these healthcare organizations will frantically hire teams to look for these clinical trials that will fit the criteria for a specific patient for that clinical trial. And that's extremely an intensive labor process where you may miss something, essentially. And a lot of the providers out there are looking for this clinical trial information, but it takes a lot of time. Now, Brian and his team over at his company have figured out a way to digitize this for all of the DrChrono providers in DrChrono in a way where while you're seeing these types of patients, you can immediately get information about what is happening with clinical trials. We have Brian here. He started the company. So I guess give us the history of like, why did you start the company? I know a little bit about your background. But I think it'd be great to hear why you even started this company around clinical trials.
Yeah, absolutely. So I started this company about 2 years ago. I was diagnosed with osteonecrosis of femoral condyle, so the end of my knee. I used to be big into powerlifting, and I was doing a very light amount of weight, and I was getting a searing pain in my knee, and I couldn't figure out what was going on. So I went to my doctor, figured out what was wrong with my knee. We got an MRI and found out that I had osteonecrosis, which typically only happens to people over 60, and so it's pretty rare for somebody of my age to get that. And the doctor informed me that there were pretty much no really good treatment options for my knee, and I really should just avoid doing heavy lifting, things like that. That would really put a lot of stress on my knee when I was in that bent position between the bottom of my knee and the top of it, causing microfractures essentially to happen where that area of osteonecrosis is. Mm. And being an entrepreneur of sorts, I decided that that wasn't the answer I was going to take, and I wanted to work on a solution that would help people like me who don't have cures for their conditions very good treatment options to actually be able to bring these new treatment options to market for people like me. And it's not even just me. So that was kind of the catalyst of me getting started in it. And so I just realized, you know, this is something I really wanted to work on. So we got to work in the company. We initially were trying to go direct to patient to help them find clinical trial options, but we found that without access to their medical record, determined this patient's actually a good candidate for clinical trials. On top of that, as the doctor, typically the patient would first thing to do is they take their clinical trial with the doctor, and doctors are going to say, like, you know, this actually isn't a good idea, or like, this is a good idea. Again, they may have missed the eligibility window criteria. So we want to help figure out that, hey, if your doctor realizes, hey, we can present these clinical trials to you for this specific patient, you can quickly glance at it and just know, oh, this is something that would be a better treatment option for my patient that I currently haven't been offering to them. We make you be able to figure out which clinical trials are good for that patient immediately without having to spend any time searching through clinicaltrials.gov, checking its inclusion, exclusion criteria. We automate that whole process and allow you to get involved in the clinical research process and offer those new treatment options to your patients.
What is the cost of this to the DrChrono practices, the providers?
Exactly. And so the great thing for the provider yourself, it's actually a completely free integration. So you can install this with one click, hdphealth.com/DrChrono. You can sign up, click install, and our plugin will be live within your integration instance of DrChrono. You can really begin finding clinical trials for your patient. So as a free integration, one of the things that we also help you do is if you decide that your organization would like to run clinical research, we can help identify what new clinical research options that are coming out and would be a good fit for your patients. So maybe you have 5 or 10 patients that would all be a good fit for this one new clinical trial that's launching in, say, 2 or 3 months. We can go broker the deal to have you become a site to run this clinical trial. And not only are you now able to offer this amazing new treatment options for your patients, but we also allow you to make new revenue by running this clinical trial. So the actual sponsor of the trial, whether it's a pharma company or device company, will pay you to run this clinical trial at your organization. So you get the double benefit of increasing the revenue of your organization and offering new treatment options to your existing patients without having to do any work.
because it's a free integration, who funds, how do you sustain your company, and how is this free to the providers?
Exactly. So, so we're sustained. So we have a very set of good investors who have funded us the initial development of this company. And moving forward, the pharmaceutical companies actually pay us as a company to be around to make sure we can find patients that would be good for their pharmaceutical clinical trials. And that's kind of how we fund ourselves.
So the pharmaceutical companies, when there's a patient that is a correct fit for a clinical trial, that's sort of like a win for you. Yeah. It's a win for the doctor. It's a win for the patient, everybody.
And kind of to take a step back at how it works is, so we one of the big privacy things is, so we don't share any information about your patients with the pharmaceutical companies. What we do is we tell them, hey, here is a good site, and we'll connect them with you as the doctor to determine with the pharmaceutical company if this is a clinical trial that you would like to open up at your site. And so there's no information shared back and forth, but if we would broker these deals so a pharmaceutical company knows to approach you to run some of these clinical trials, that would be a good fit for the patients that you're already treating.
Another thing that I found super interesting about you, Brian, you are a technical single founder, and he was able to build on the DrChrono API very, very, very quickly, getting a version one out extremely fast. The way that he actually finds clinical trials, he actually links through the API, mm-hmm. right?
Yep.
And then you're looking for specific information.
Yep. So how we do this is, so we look across your patient base. And one of the cool things that we do is, so typical companies who maybe you're looking for a clinical trial, you're searching through your patient data. You would just search the different ICD codes. Maybe, you know, we know these patients have these ICD-10 codes that mark these conditions, and they have these different treatments we've given them before. And based on that, we'll determine, you know, are they a fit for this clinical trial or not. But one of the cool things that we offer from a technical perspective is when we analyze the data of your patients, any clinical notes that you have typed up about your patient, we can actually run through all of your clinical notes and turn any values inside there that are currently unsearchable into a list of ICD-10 codes, SNOMED codes, other structured variables that you can use to identify your patients and determine if they're actually a fit for your clinical trials. So we kind of give a better look. If you're only looking at half the data for what's good for your patient, you're not really finding the best option for them. Really will help you look through the entire data of your patients quickly and seamlessly.
So there's
your practice workflow.
So there's the note. You pull the note and you're extracting codes.
Yep.
And you mentioned AI, so you have like an AI algorithm that's working.
So we have an AI algorithm that that runs all of the notes, turns different sentences into similar structures, compares those against every single medical criteria that's out there, whether it's an ICD-10 code, ICD-9 code, SNOMED code. We'll go through all of your criteria of a patient, whether it's typed up, and determine if they match against different things, and then create a way for the computer to search against that in a way that's not currently available to medical records. And the artificial intelligence continues to learn off of itself and improving itself over time.
And you are live in a hospital network.
Yep.
Congratulations on that.
Thank you.
So product is being used at the hospital level. I think we are the first integration at like the ambulatory outside hospital level.
Correct. Yep.
So you're launching this to DrChrono users first for all of you, where you get the benefit. And the thing that I see the benefit of this is it makes you, as the provider, look more informed and look better, right? So if you have if your patient walks in, and this is a patient that you feel as the provider could maybe benefit from a clinical trial, you simply tap a few buttons. Now, a question I have for you, Brian, is how fast do you pull up clinical trial data to give back to the provider?
It's a mix right now. A number of the clinical trials, we can get back an initial report instantaneously, actually.
Okay.
Right now, what we do, as we're since we're so early, to make sure there's no kinks in the system, we actually have internal clinical staff who have spent a combined actually 40 years working in hospital systems, manually finding patients to be recruited to clinical trials. Hmm. And so at the moment, we actually have our staff take a look over the report that we're generating for you.
Make sure
the report's actually a very good report.
Okay.
And not giving you some garbage data. So this is like from experience, to make sure this, and then we deliver that report to you. That process typically takes a full 24 hours, possibly 48 if it's a weekend or a holiday. But that report comes pretty quickly. Yeah,
that's still really fast. So if a patient comes in a dire situation and you feel like they're a good fit for a clinical trial, tap a few buttons, click a few buttons.
Literally go to the DrChrono, the bottom left, there'll be a plugin for us. You can click on that. Their condition comes up. And if the report is not there already, it may have been analyzed by our system automatically and put there. But if not, you can simply request the report update for that patient. And within 24 to 48 hours at the latest,
that's fast.
We'll have a list of clinical trial options that you can enroll that patient in. So now when they see that article on Facebook talking about this new magical treatment that came out their condition, you may have access to telling them, hey, here's that actual treatment as a clinical trial, and we can discuss about them being enrolled in that new treatment.
And I guess the product itself is free. Mm-hmm. You are paid by the pharmaceutical company.
Yeah.
Is there any benefit to the doctor other than looking really good to the patient, patient taking care of the patient? Is there any like monetary benefit or anything there?
Yeah, and certainly so. So the biggest one is there's actually two. We have one live right now. So if we look at your patient base, we find a clinical trial that's being opened in say 3 months and you want to open that clinical trial, you can get paid to run that clinical trial at your site, which generates new revenue for your organization. Without having to do any extra work of finding new patients or determining if they're eligible for your clinical trials or not. All you do is enable our solution. We tell you a clinical trial, you decide to open it with the pharma company, and you generate new revenue off your patient base. A second solution we're working on in the future is actually, if you don't want to run the clinical trial but do want to get them involved, actually getting paid to just simply screen the patient if they're eligible or not is something that we're working towards doing as well. And so if your practice is looking for new ways to generate revenue, offer new treatments to your patients, the HDP Health integration with DrChrono is a great way to do that.
Well, thank you so much, Brian, for being here. Looking forward to our providers using your software. Awesome. Thank you.